Hey, hi, Sherbert here. How are you? Are you doing good? I hope so. I hope you're doing good. It's a good day. Why not? Let's make it again. So this is my Fortnite early impressions. What is the game video? Because I was recently gifted the game by a friend, so I figured I would talk about the game and what I do and don't like and go from there. So first off, thank you, whoever gifted me the game. You know who you are, and I thoroughly appreciate it. This game's been so much fun to play. So I'm just going to talk about kind of the lore of the game, how the game works, some specific mechanics, and then get into the more opinionated, what I do and don't like. And then, I don't know, we'll take it from there. So sorry if this video is all over the place. I've got an extremely loose structure to this video. So what is Fortnite? Fortnite is a third-person shooter tower defense builder game where you play as one of many heroes and defend an objective with the fort you've built, with the resources you've gathered from zombie-esque creatures. So the lore of the game is really simple. A big storm came and killed a bunch of, like, 90% of the population, and you've got to find those living population and fend away from these creature things that are attacking for no one knows why. So that's the lore. So let's kind of talk about how the basic formula for how the game works. The game starts, you get to choose a mission from a nicely generated map screen, and then from there you are quickly partied up. You can change the settings of the party if you only want to play with your friends, or if you're fine playing with randoms on the internet, which is really nice. My first thing that I already really like about the game is that the party system is super convenient, and I've yet to spend more than 3 minutes waiting for someone in a game, which is great, because not having to wait means I get to play more, and it's good. So you finally get into the game, hooray, you've selected your hero, da 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 da. I'll talk about the heroes and everything later. You load into the map, you go around and look for the objective on the map while looking for resources. Once you find the objective, you build a fort to defend the objective from these husks creatures that they're called, and then the video's over, or not the video, then the game's over, and you move on to the next map. Just keeping in stream with this, the one thing that I don't like so far about the game, one of the things, is that all the game modes are unbelievably similar. There is actually no difference between them. It's just, do you want to defend this one place for a few times with a bunch of different waves, or one time for a really long time? That's the difference between the game modes so far. I mean, this is only a week into the game's release. I suspect more to come out, no problem, because supposedly the game has sold almost 500,000 copies on its first day of release, which is fantastic. Good for Epic Games. So, alrighty, now just before we get into the nitty-gritty of how the game functions, and let's talk about the general hardware. The game runs great. It's on Unreal 4, so it's a great-looking game. I imagine we'll be seeing way more AAA Unreal 4 titles in the next 5 years, maybe 2 years, if even in the near future. Recording OBS Studio on the game at a decent hardware setup, playing the game on all medium graphics with a far render distance. I play 60 frames flat, no problem, which is fantastic. Continuing from there, the art style of the game. The game is fantastic looking, like I said, on Unreal 4, so already the shaders, the textures are all great. And the art style of the game is wonderful. It's kind of, I don't know if you remember Battleborn, the 2K games made. It's very reminiscent of that. It's kind of, it's cartoony, but with some realistic elements, but it is not afraid to show its face that it is a cartoony, cel-shaded, I think is the word, styled game that it's going for. So it's good. It's a pretty game, it's got a distinct look, and it runs well. So baseline, there isn't any issues with. It's a little bit hardware intensive, but you should be okay to run it at low with the even low end setup. So going from there, so I've already talked about how the gathering and the material gathering and getting to the objective. So now backtracking to when you choose your hero, you choose your hero from one of four classes. You're either an engineer, an outlander, a ninja, or a soldier, which each are good at their own things, and you choose from one of many characters in those roles, and you get to. So what each of them do, I'm just going to talk about. So the engineer builds things better and for less materials and stronger. The ninja can double jump, And has an array of abilities. The soldier shoots real good, has bombs, and can call in airstrikes. The Outlander can dash around and use various nodes, which are little things that, when you activate them, give you a speed boost. Can take those and turn them into a variety of interesting things, such as a material-based pinata that gives you a bunch of materials, or a robot that will proceed to tell everyone that they are not bears, which is kind of annoying, actually. But just going from there, once you get into the game as one of your heroes, you go and break stuff. You gather stuff to build for your fort. So the game is based around one of... There's three major materials. There are wood, stone, and... Or no, wood, brick, and steel. And you build your structures, which you have four structure schematics. So the building system, by the way, is fantastic. I'll talk about that in a minute. There is a wall schematic, a floor schematic, a stair schematic, and a pyramid structure schematic. So everything in the game is built from those four schematics. So it's unbelievably simple, and you're only limited by your imagination. I can make a whole video on how much I love the building system. It's fantastic. Everything is unbelievably fluid, even while in combat, which is really impressive. And just building these great, massive structures and forts to defend is awesome. So, oh, you also have one more schematic, which is the trap schematic. So you can place traps on the wall, on the ceiling, on the floor. It's interesting. So all the things that I've talked about, the weapon, I haven't talked about the weapons. There's guns in the games. There is snipers, assault rifles, rocket launchers, a multitude of things. All of which, the game is completely schematic based. When you're scavenging around for resources, like I said, you can find some of these things. Not like just pre-made, so not a schematic, but you can find a weapon in a trash can or a trap in a bed or something. So how you make those consistently, though, is with schematics that you get either through the storyline quests, which are just simple little things such as go into an area, do the objective, but do this little side thing before you do build a fort and defend the main objective. But all those schematics, and then how you progress in the game, is there's different levels of schematics. So there's the commons, the rares, the epics, and then the legendaries. So obviously legendaries being the best ones, and you get those out of these either as quest objectives, or you get them through the microtransaction, which are llamas. They're little floating pinatas. They're llamas that talk to you before you hit them. And you get a chance, like any microtransaction, to get a rare llama, and you get rare items. It's cute, but like anything microtransaction-based, it's what it is. It's a microtransaction. So one thing with the llamas is you can either get weapon schematics, you can get trap schematics, or you can get survivors and defenders, which are just... Is the survivors, you make squads, which are just an excuse for them to draw art as people, and they just give you passive buffs, and that's it. That's another thing you get from the llamas. So when you get in the game, you've got, this is my next complaint kind of segueing, is you've got health, shields, stamina, and stamina. So stamina you use when you are running outside of the game. Or when you're running, or when you're using one of your various character abilities that I talked about earlier. So the one thing that I have already run into that is unbelievably irritating is that running takes stamina outside of combat. It feels unnecessary, and it makes the game 1,000 times slower than it needs to be, because searching for resources it isn't streamlined. You have to constantly wait and hear one of your characters say one of four voice lines, which is funny for about 10 minutes, and then you start mocking them, repeating them, and get irritating. So that's one thing that's really annoying. So one change that was proposed on the subreddit that I really liked was to make stamina not really count until you get inside of combat with the husks, which they're scattered across the map, just in little encampments and little groups before you get to the actual physical objective fighting. So that's... But the reason the stamina exists is because the ninja, some of their abilities require stamina. Double jumping, for instance, requires them to spend 50 energy out of a base 100. Well, ninjas have more stamina than every other class, but it's a lot. And then they also have to use their energy for their abilities. So to lower the costs, everyone being the community, is going to be the next big change. My last real complaint with the game so far, my last two complaints before, is that the level design thus far, while is really beautiful, as I've said, the level's great, the aesthetics are awesome, it gets repetitive. And switching from one area to other, for example, Stonewood to Plankerton, it doesn't feel like I've progressed in the game. It just feels like the enemies have gotten harder and the environment's still the same. This is something I'm being told they're worked on, so it should be no problem. And to wrap up this video, because it's getting a little lengthy, my final complaint is that the classes don't feel distinct enough. And I'm told that my thought process is, as you get further into the game and you get more skill points and more leveled up, your classes become more special and distinct. But as of right now, early mid to the game, it feels as though my class is almost irrelevant and that I'm not distinct enough from the other ones. While I have my abilities, it just feels like me, as I play primarily the engineer, I have no reason to not just play a soldier or ninja and just kill everything until an engineer is actually needed once the game gets harder. I've been told the game gets a lot harder that once you get to the second stage, so I'll have to check back if this video gets enough. I'll probably make the video anyways. I'll have to check back and tell you how this is compared with my thoughts in, per se, a week or so. So there you go. There's my thoughts on Fortnite currently. I like the game a lot, and I'm hoping to make more content. If this gets even a little bit of attention, I'd like to have that happen. So if you like this video, let me know. Put it in likes. If you disagree or agree with anything I said, put it in the comments. I'm always reading those, and so I'll respond to you. Love to have good discussion about this stuff, especially about things I like. So thank you so much. Sorry if this video dragged on a bit. Just had a lot to say. Thank you so much, and have a great day.